Hi, I'm Gaylerd. Welcome back. Hey, now that you've learned the fretboard notes for E minor, it's time to have fun using them to create a few easy riffs to use as transitions. So just to make sure you remember, fretboard notes are not scales. Fretboard notes are the notes that are associated with a particular open chord that acoustic guitar players use to create wow factor. Now remember, you can create a pattern with as many or as few of those notes as you like, and you can play them in any random order you wish. What you're trying to do is to build cool melodic riffs that you can use as chord fills and transitions, because that's what will keep your audience interested and anticipating what you're going to do on your guitar next. That's why it's so important to be able to use the right fretboard notes with each and every chord. It adds spice and flavor to what you're playing. So the more skills you have using fretboard chord notes, the closer you are to becoming the guitar player other guys want to be. So let's dig in and get started building a few easy four-note riffs that you can use with the E minor. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. I'm going to take one of those common chord progressions that we just learned in the previous lesson for E minor, and we're going to use the common chord progression, the 1, 6, 3, 7 progression, the E minor, C, G, and D. And then we're going to create 5 really easy riff patterns that you can use as chord transitions from the 1 chord to the 2 chord. That's it. The 3 and 4 chord, we're just going to strum them. We'll use accent strumming, but we're just going to strum them. All I want you to do now is learn to use a riff pattern, a transition from the 1 to the 2 chord. Now here's the riff pattern, or I'm sorry, here's the strumming pattern that we're going to use, and it'll be real simple, just like this. Just listen to the scratching, and then I'm going to play the chords with it so you hear the accent. It'll be like this. Now, if I play chords with it, it would be like this. Now, I'm throwing some accents in just to do it. I just want you to hear it. Now it's important that you get that strumming down. If I'm playing that too fast, you can slow it down. People that are taking these lessons are at all different levels. So if that's too fast, you can slow it down. But here's what you're going to do to get into your transition. We're going to accent the E minor, we're going to accent the C and the G, and then we'll be strumming on the D. So it'll be like this. I'm going to play it for you and show you what I mean. There's your E minor. Okay, once you hit that E, all I want you to do is strum it one time, and then we'll do your transition to get to the C, G, D. Oh, look how fast that is. You got an E minor transition, C, G. Now I'm doing a slap. I want you to try and get your slap in E minor. Now I'm exaggerating all these moves for you so you can see what I'm doing. Once you hit that one time, is all you want to do is come down on that E minor, accent that E minor, and then we're going to do our transition. So I'm going down on that C, slap, up, down on the D. Just like that. I'm going to do it one more time. Now, if you don't want to slap, you don't have to slap. Just C, C is down, G is up, and then D is down. One more time. Down on. Okay? Whatever you can get in there, you don't have to do the exact pattern I am doing. You just want to get close to it, okay? You don't have to do the exact. This isn't the strumming exercise, it's this riff. So here's what we're going to do. You're going to hit that E minor, and then your first pattern is just on this fifth string. Just like that. That's all we're doing. and then you hit that C, G, and do up on a G, so it'll make it easier for you, and then down on D, E minor. I'm purposely in this exercise, we're not blending it right in with the chord. I just want you to learn how to put that transition in. Then you're gonna hear that little pause after that E. Pause. Whoops. You could actually, if you want to, on that C, like that, and then come up on the G. One, two, three, up, down. Like that, okay? That's your first pattern. Now I want you to practice that, and what you want to make sure that you're getting those notes in nice and clean before you go to that C, and your C chord needs to be clean, G needs to be clean, and D needs to be clean. All right, now that's your first one. Now let me show you riff number two. Okay, now riff number two, we're gonna go down from the fourth string down to the fifth, and it'll be just a little walk down, two open, two on four, just like that. And I'll put those riffs up, or the tab up there for you. If you can't do it that fast, you can slow it. One more time. Okay. So practice that, make sure you're able to get those two nice and clean. Now let me show you riff number three. Okay, riff number three, you're gonna use your pinky. Remember I've been telling you, you gotta be able to use all your fingers on these riffs. So hopefully you practice that E minor tab and you're able to get those fingers moving there. So here's what you're gonna do on this one. While you're strumming, we're gonna use the pinky, third on two, open. And all you're doing there, second on three, open three, and then you get right to your C. That muscle memory is gonna come in critical here now. So it's like this. Notice what I'm doing on that D chord. I'm kind of doing an upbeat to get accent on it. Now it's going to be important here, when you hit that, you may want to take your fingers off of that fretboard completely to get into that note. And that's okay because you're doing it quick. I'm going to slow it down a little bit. Now, something else that you want to watch. Remember, we were doing practicing our picking back and forth. Since I'm going from the floor to the ceiling, that first note I'm picking up. Now you can do on that third one, I'm going down on it. It's up to you on that third string if you want to pick down on that third note or up, however you want to do it. But you're better off picking up on that third fret on that second string. Now, if you don't pick up, if you decide to pick down, you gotta be picking up when you play it open because you want your hand going back and forth on those strings. Mess that up. Okay, let me show you the fourth riff. Okay, and on this fourth riff, we're going to use our pinky and our middle finger to do the riff. Now here's what's important. You've got to be able to do all of those fingers, practice all those fingers. If you're not able to do that, go back on that original lesson and learn how to use all your fingers and back and forth picking motion, because it's going to get tougher and you don't want to get way behind. Just keep practicing until you're able to do this smooth. This riff is going to be like this. Second fret on three, open, then I'm using my middle finger. Second fret on four, open, C. Now you could do, you can use that finger on both of them, but you really want to practice using different fingers. You could use the middle finger for both those runs. Here we go again. Now let me show you the fifth riff. Okay, this fifth riff is going to be a nice easy one, just a walk up, and you're going to go open on sixth string, open two, three, open five, and then your C chord. Don't get stuck on using the same fingers. Try using different fingers on that riff. That's what you can get ready to do. There's all kinds of things that you're going to have so much fun learning all this stuff. So here we go. Practice, and I'll see you in the next video.